have radiators in your home, then don't stop watching, as the things that you are about to see here can save you money or time or even both in the long run, as we are going to talk about intelligent temperature control with Home Assistant and TRV, where TRV stands for Thermostatic Radiator Valves, and Home Assistant stands for... You know that! Or if you don't, check my free webinar at automatelike.pro/webinar, where I'm talking about that in details. Back to TRVs. They can be manually adjusted, that is the old and boring way, where you have to go through each and every radiator and close the valve every time you wish to open the window, for example. Or a TRV can be smart and they can be controlled remotely, either from a mobile app or even better, from a centralized system like Home Assistant. A great example of a smart thermostatic radiator valve or TRV is the new Shelly TRV. And guess what? I have one right here. As always, I'm going to add it to Home Assistant and I'll make some real life Home Assistant automations for you. But first, let's see the good and the bad of the Shelly TRV. I will list several Shelly TRV features that grabbed my attention when I initially saw it. First, it was very easy to install Shelly TRV. I just had to remove my old TRV to fully open the old valve and to unscrew the metal ring. There are several adapters that are included in the Shelly TRV package. They are RA, RAVL and RAV. Also, there is a PDF with a lot of pictures where you can check if the Shelly TRV will fit your radiator. So, check that first and if necessary, mount the suitable adapter before installation. In my case, the adapter was right and I didn't have to change anything. Then, I had to install the Shelly TRV by fastening the metal ring clockwise. When everything was done, a brief press of the reset button was needed to turn on the device. And then I heard the motor inside that was going through the calibration process. If the calibration process is successful, the screen will display AP and the device will be ready to be connected to the Wi-Fi network. To add the Shelly TRV to your Wi-Fi network, Shelly mobile app is needed, which is available in both Apple and Android stores for free. I will not go through the pairing process as it is very, very easy. You just have to follow the instructions that the Shelly mobile app will provide. Instead, I will continue with the other things that I liked about the Shelly TRV. And the next one was the battery. Because Shelly TRV is a battery powered device, and that battery can last up to 2 years, and after that, you just have to recharge it with a USB-C cable. To fully charge it, around 5 hours are needed. However, maybe because of the battery, the size of the Shelly TRV is a bit big. And if you are tight on the space, this could be a problem, so check that in advance. Shelly is a well-known brand in the smart home world, as they already have some killer products like their smart relays. But it is not only that. Their software and their APIs allowing you to connect their products to practically any decent smart home hubs without any modifications of the Shelly devices. Flashing custom firmwares like Tasmota or ESP Home is also not needed, as you can natively use REST, MQTT and CoAP protocols to connect the Shelly TRV to any smart home system you wish. Of course, integration with voice assistant like Amazon Echo and Google Home is also officially supported and possible. Shelly TRV is compatible out of the box with Home Assistant, and now is the best time to show you that in details. After I successfully added the Shelly TRV in the Shelly Cloud app, I'll open my Home Assistant and I'll go to Configuration, Devices and Services, Add Integration, and I'll search for Shelly. Here it is. It found one of my devices, but I want the Shelly TRV. So I'll enter the Shelly TRV IP. I'll get that from my router. Where it is? Here it is. I'll copy the IP of my Shelly TRV and I'll paste it in this dialog. And then I'll click submit. I have to wake it up. So I'll press one of the buttons. It failed to connect.
Second attempt.
I'll copy the IP. I'll open a new tab and I'll paste the IP right here. This is the Shelly TRV web interface. I'll go to Internet and Security, Coyote. I'll enable this. As a remote address, I'll type my Home Assistant IP. And as port, I will use the unicast port 5683. And I'll hit save. Now I want to restart the device by going to settings, device reboot, yes.
One, reboot, later.
Okay, the device is up and running. I'll go again to my Home Assistant. And I will enter the IP of my Shelly TRV. I'll click on one of the buttons to wake the device up and I'll click submit. Success! Created configuration for Shelly TRV, something, probably the MAC address of the device. Finish. And I have Shelly TRV in my Home Assistant as one device and two entities. If I click on it, I can see some readings, currently 20 degrees Celsius, the battery level and the heating. I can add this to Lovelace, add to Lovelace UI, and my Shelly TRV is here. If I try to control it, nothing happens. If I click on this, yes, I turn it off and I cannot turn it on for some reason. Okay, I turn it on. Let's see. 100% yes. Okay, I can control my Shelly TRV from Home Assistant, which is perfect. Let's continue further. If you want to buy some Shelly TRVs, you can use the affiliate link in the video description, where I will receive a small commission from your purchases with no additional cost for you. Anyways, there is no real use of just adding the Shelly TRV to Home Assistant and then nothing else. That is why I will show you two real life Home Assistant Shelly TRV automations that I think will be useful for you. The first one is temperature based. Shelly TRV have integrated temperature sensor, but because every radiator mounted thermostat has a slight deviation from the actual room temperature, since the temperature measurement is performed too closely to the radiator, I will use my $5 DIY temperature and humidity sensor added in Home Assistant as external temperature sensor to control the Shelly TRV. Based on this temperature sensor, if the temperature inside my room goes above 22 degrees Celsius, the automation will stop the Shelly TRV and the radiator. Respectively, if the temperature inside goes below 20 degrees, the Home Assistant automation will start the Shelly TRV. But let's see that in action. Okay, currently my Shelly TRV is set to the lowest possible value. That means the valve is almost closed. The current temperature in my living room is 22.4 degrees Celsius and I want to create an automation that will monitor this value right here and if it goes below 20 degrees to start the Shelly TRV. Let's begin. I'll go to configuration, automation and scenes and I'll add a new automation. I'll start with an empty automation. I'll name that automation Shelly TRV below 20. For example, the trigger will be numeric state. My entity of interest will be my DIY temperature and humidity sensor, which is called living room temperature. And if the value of this sensor goes below 20 degrees, I can even set for how long this state should hold. For example, 1 minute, 1 hour, whatever. But I'll leave it like that, just for the test. And I'll go directly to the action section. For the action, I'll choose call service. As service, I want to invoke the climate set temperature. My target will be my Shelly TRV entity. And as temperature, I'll set 30. This is the maximum value that Shelly TRV can accept. And basically that means turn on the valve at 100%. And I think I'm ready. I'll click save. This is how the YAML looks like. But it doesn't matter. Let's test this. I'll open my developer tools. And I'll select the states tab. As set state, I'll search for my living room temperature. The current state is 22.5, and again my thermostat is almost closed. I'll simulate that temperature of this living room sensor goes below 20. For example, let's set it to 19, and I'll click set state. And immediately the Shelly TRV goes to 30 degrees Celsius, which is 100% opened. If I go back and I click on this three-dot menu, then on duplicate automation, edit in visual mode, I will slightly change the same automation. I'll set this name for above 23, for example. I'll remove this duplicate text. I'll remove this below and I'll set 23, above 23. The trigger will be if the temperature goes above 23 degrees Celsius. And the action will be not 30 but 0 or 5. I don't care. I can set whatever I wish here, but let's set it to 0. I'll hit save. And I'm ready to test it. Currently the Shelly TRV is 100% opened, set to 30 degrees Celsius. If I go again to the developer tools and set my sensor to 24, I'll activate my second automation and the Shelly TRV should become 0 or low. Yes. It is working. The automations are working perfectly. Of course, I can make this in one automation using trigger IDs, but that's another story.
In case you're a bit lost with the words and abbreviations that I used during this video, go to my website, KPeyanski.com/glossary, and download my smart home PDF glossary, which is absolutely free. I'm Kirill. And I'm done speaking. Bye!